Holy frick, I'm so excited. All right. Love is so short, forgetting is so long. Oh, gosh.
Are you for real?
What do you mean?
I don't know. I just feel like maybe I made you up.
Wait, that's so cute. I love that. This one's also directed by Taylor Swift. Taylor Swift's becoming a filmmaker, y'all. Hey, that's good editing. I love how she was looking up, and then it motivates this cut to this sky shot where we can show the titles. And I left my scarf there. Y'all, I have to pause here. This is good storytelling, bro. This is, the lyrics are being just eloquently illustrated through this dreamy film-like look. And I love how, I don't know if this is actually shot on film, but it really feels like it, which gives it such a dreamy, beautiful unicorn look, you know? And it's so good. You've still got it in your drawer even now. Coming to that wide right when the beat comes in is so good. This is a movie, man. This is so notice how all the cutting is pretty slow, and every single shot has a purpose. That's the thing we got to remember about narrative filmmaking, is every single shot has a purpose. There's a reason why it's there, and if there isn't a reason why it's there, cut the shot. Cut the shot. And Taylor's doing a great job, and whoever edited this is doing a fantastic job. And holding a little bit longer than you think on shots also feels so nice. Just really get to be inside of their brains and inside of their lives. This is such a money shot, bro. Oh my gosh. The genius part about this shot, guys, if you notice, if we go back to the beginning of it, is the camera isn't moving at the beginning, and then right when they start kissing, the camera just starts spinning around them. And the spinning around them camera is the feeling that you get when you're falling in love. It's just the world is spinning around you. Nothing else matters except for you two in that moment. And that's why this camera movement and just deciding to hold on this shot and extend the moment feels like how time slows down when you're falling in love. Yes, this is so freaking good, bro. Such a good filmmaking choice. Have any of y'all done that? Have you, like, remember the times where we used to share headphones? Man, I remember being on the bus, being with my boy Josiah. He's my best friend from you know, back in the day, back in the good old days. We'd be sharing earbuds from his iPod. That's just straight nostalgia, bro. You see that little circle? Do you guys wonder what that little circle is? It's called a cigarette burn, which confirms that this is film. And at the beginning and end of reels, they'll do like a little hole through the film, which is called a cigarette burn. And there it was. So if you're ever wondering, why the frick was there a circle in the middle of that shot? It's because it's a cigarette burn for one frame. First crack in the glass. No! No cracks in the glass! I'm sorry, y'all. I am so enveloped in the story that it's just hard to comment. It's hard to comment, but the way that they're just holding on shots just is so, so good for my editing heart because they're not overcutting. Overcutting is one of the biggest mistakes that editors make, and all you have to do is hold on shots that help tell the story and then get out of it when it's done. And they're doing that. Nah, see, an action speaks so much louder than words, y'all. That's just a good directing tip. He just comes up, puts his dishes in the sink. Men, do your own dishes, bro, or do her dishes. You should not be... Man, we gotta step it up, man.
These are my friends.
Notice how we haven't cut yet. It's been one shot the whole time.
Well, I liked your friends. I never said I didn't like your friends. I didn't like the way that you acted around them.
You were being weird and quiet the entire time.
I was not being weird because you wouldn't look at me.
Oh, come on. It's fucking crazy. These are people I haven't seen in like 10 years. And you just sit there the entire fucking time. It was fun. I actually had a fucking blast. Now this is the night. Now we're doing this.
Bro, the fact that he just keeps putting dishes in the sink just makes it feel so much worse. He's just heaping more things on top of her physically, like physically putting stuff, and then verbally and mentally, he's just heaping stuff on top of her. It's so freaking good.
What are you talking about?
Oh, no,
you.
No,
I'm catching up with my friends.
Oh, trust me, they were enthralled by you. Of course.
I'm so, you're literally making the entire night about
you.
You
didn't even look at me.
Holy shit. I can't. It's fucking selfish. It's literally like, it's so crazy.
Oh,
you're making
so you're selfish
it about,
now.
Yes,
selfish
you're making
now.
It about, you're acting, so I'm seeing you're acting selfish. Absolutely. Right now, that's exactly what's happening. Don't fucking look at me like that. That's so fucked up.
There's the cut. And then we cut right there. That's such a long freaking shot, bro. That's so good. Staying on one shot makes the scene feel way, way more real. Not to mention we have great acting, great dialogue, everything. But the scene feels so much more real because we just stayed on one shot. We're not interrupting reality with cuts, which is
exactly what's happening.
It's just one
don't fucking
continuous
like that.
Tape.
So fucked up.
And then that cut is motivated because we need to see how she's looking at him. It's very important
for the audience
to see that.
Hey. Come on. I'm sorry.
Are you? It's so crazy, bro. This is just how relationships be. This is how they be. It's a ebb and flow. It's up and down. It's a roller coaster ride. I'm just halfway done with this movie and I already can't. This camera work is so intimate. Showing their hands is such an interesting choice. It's a good match cut, y'all. Hands to hands. It's so interesting. You can tell so much of a story by just showing somebody's hands. No! This is not what I'm here for, bro. I don't want to be sad. Y'all, this is a filmmaking masterpiece. The reason why this scene works so well is because we decide not to cut and show him because he's not important. He's not the main character. We have to stay on our girl. We have to stay on our protagonist. And we have to see how she's reacting because we know what's happening in the scene. And all we want to do is stay on her reaction. Stay on her reaction. That's all that's important. And so choosing to not cut to him is one of the best choices ever. Stay on her reaction. Because he's obviously like, we know as an audience what's happening. We had the title and then we see this. And then we just stay on her. That's all we have to do. And then that shot paired with the lyrics, so good. It hurts, bro. I'm so close to crying, bro. I'm so close. This is a perfect representation of relationships. It's you're at a party, it's awkward, you see their friends after you broke up, oh my gosh. I just feel, the way that this was shot too, you don't see anybody's faces and you only see her face, it's pretty genius. Because you can really feel the claustrophobia that she's feeling. And then, when she sees something important, you cut to recognizable faces. Just cutting to new shots also on new phrases of the song, so good. So we just chill. There's a chill moment in the song, just a slow instrumental, and then we're just chilling overhead, just going inside of her world. And then once a new phrase starts, it's like we cut to a new scene. By it. I'd like to it's be great. My it's simple, but it's very, very effective. I'm still trying to find it after Privet. Cause you remember it all too well. Showing these memories and then going back to him walking. Bro, I'm not emotionally ready for this. This is hard to take in, bro. Thank you guys for coming on this journey with me. Holy frick. All right, we're almost there, y'all. 30 years. Okay, 30 years. All right. 13. Okay, I can't read. Got it. 13 years. I was about to say, she's about to be old. Ha! I know who that is. I guess it's a fact. Nah, that's storytelling. This is the thing. This is the thing about music videos. You can't completely tell a moving story within 3 minutes. I mean, you can, but it's so hard. That's why you need something that's, you know, in the 10 to 20 minute range, which this is. And y'all, people that watch this are going to be emotionally affected because you were able to show the scarf in the beginning and set that up as something that's going to be a through line throughout the whole story. That's why we hung on that shot in the beginning. And then we're at the end and we understand what the scarf means. And in her success, we see her ex looking in, the true love. Oh my gosh. That's a beautiful through line. Taylor, go off, girl. Jesus loves you. I love you guys. Subscribe.